Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to see few shortcuts which will help to solve any dice problem very easily, okay? First, let's see few basics of solving dice problem, okay? When you have one dice, the maximum value that is possible from the one dice are, you may get 1 or you may get 2, you may get answer as 3, you may get answer as 4, or you may get direct maximum number as an answer, okay? Understood? When you throw one dice, these are the probabilities you can get, okay? Minimum will be 1 and maximum will be 6, okay? And coming to two dice, when you have two dice, okay, you can get 1-2 as answer, or 2-1 as answer, or you can get 2-2, like first dice gave answer as 2 and second dice also you got the number 2, or first dice can give 3, second dice can give 2, or first dice can give 5, second dice can give 6. Like this, totally you will be having 36 different probabilities when you throw two dice, okay? When you throw two dice, 36 cases you will get like this, like 1-2, like first dice gave 1, second dice gave 2, first dice gave 2, second dice gave 1 as a number, like this you will be having 36 different probabilities, okay? So now what we have to do is we will see what is the shortcut to solve the problem, dice problem, okay? The questions will be like, what is the probability when we get 10 as sum by throwing two dice, okay? Let this be the question, okay? Like, when we throw two dice, we are getting sum. What is the probability that we are getting sum as 10 when we throw two dice, okay? First, what we need to do is just draw a triangle, okay? And after drawing a triangle, what you need to do is the minimum number which is possible after throwing two dice. Okay, this is dice 1, this is dice 2. Okay, minimum possibility is from the dice 1, you can get 1. From the dice 2, you can get 2. Okay, sorry, 1. From dice 1, you can get minimum number possible is 1. From the dice 2, you can get the minimum possibility as 1. Okay, 1 plus 1 is 2. So, the minimum number possible when you throw 2 dice is 2. So, write 2 here. Okay. And maximum number which is possible when you throw 2 dice are dice 1 and dice 2. Okay. Maximum number is, when you throw dice 1, you can get the maximum number possible 6. When you throw dice 2, you can get the maximum number possible as 6. And when you add both, maximum number when you add both is 12. Okay, put here. And the numbers which are in between 2 to 12, just keep writing equally. Okay, 3, 4, 5, 6, okay, here we have to write 7 because this is equal portion, right? Next, 8, 9, 10, 11, okay? See, this side we have 5 numbers, this side we have 5 numbers. So, that's why we wrote 7 in the middle, okay? Now, what we need to do is, okay, now let's see what we can do, okay? First, when you consider dice 1, What are the numbers which is possible? You can get as answer. Dice one can throw 1 or 2 or 3, so on up to 6. Okay, when you throw dice 1, you can get 6 possibilities. Okay, as a solution. So inside, what you need to do is write the numbers. You may get minimum as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 for dice 1. Okay. This side same. Do the same thing. Start from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6 is already there. So no need to write. I'll explain you again. See, students, first what we did is we considered dice 1 plus 2. Okay. Means dice 1 and dice 2. Okay. The minimum possible number which we throw 2 dice is 1 and 1. Okay. So total 2. So we wrote 2 here. The maximum number which is possible when we throw dice 1 and dice 2 are 6, 6. When we add, we get 12. Okay. So we wrote here and we just wrote the remaining numbers 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and all. Okay. Why we wrote 7 in the middle is that 5 equal numbers we wrote here and next 5 equal numbers we wrote here and 1 is the, this is the extra number, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 numbers I wrote in the left hand side and 5 numbers on the right hand side. This is the extra number, so I have written in the middle portion, okay? So, these are the numbers which I wrote considering 2 dice. Now, what I did is, just I am considering dice 1 or dice 2, but only 1 dice I am considering. Then, what are the possible solutions I get when I throw dice 1? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Like any of these numbers I can get as an answer when I throw 1 dice. So I did the same. I wrote 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. I consider dice 1, right? Now I am considering the dice 2. Same with dice 2. When I throw dice 2, I will get any number from 1 to 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. 7 is the above number. Okay. Like 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is for the outer triangle. For inner only we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And again 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So now what we need to do is, now let us consider when we throw 2 dice. See, when we throw 2 dice, for example, dice 1, dice 2, okay? When we throw 2 dice, first dice gave the answer as 5, second dice gave the answer as 6, okay? So, what is the sum of these both? 5 plus 6 is 11, okay? Now, just see this triangle. 11, okay? We got 11 as sum, okay? Now, the probability of getting 11 is 2. Like the straight number which is for 11 is 2. So, we have the probability 2. Out of how many? See, there are, I already said you, there are totally 36 cases, okay? Like when you throw 2 dice, you will get 36 different cases. Like 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 2. 3, 2, 2, 3, 5, 6, 6, 5, 4, 5, 5, 4, like that, you'll be getting 36 cases. So, out of 36, you have 2 possibilities of getting total 11, okay? I hope you understood. Let's take another example. Dice 1 gave 4 as answer and dice 2 gave 3 as answer, okay? When we add this both, we will get 7, okay? Again, see here. In front of 7, we have 6, okay? So, answer is 6 by total number of probabilities are 36. Out of 36 times, 6 times you can get sum as 7 when you throw 2 dices, okay? Like this, you have to see, you can easily see the sum and their probability. Okay, that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more such videos. All the very best. Thank you.